Welcome to another video from Beta CAE Systems. In this video, I will present you the major developments in Topo and Mesh version 23.0. The new features can be grouped in three main categories: the creation of Topo special toolsets, the unification of Mesh and Topo toolsets, the merging of functions, and the unification of their interface. Starting with the new Topo toolsets, new process-driven toolsets, including all functionality for designer or analyst, have been created. The new toolsets include the direct functionality applicable to both FE and geometry. More specifically, the preparation toolset, a toolset focused on topological operations and cleanup, which can be used for cases that extensive topological operations and cleanup is needed. The design toolset, which is the evolution of classic Topo and hosts ANSA CAD functionality. The Design for Analyst toolset, analyst countermeasures for design optimization. And the IGA toolset, which is a dedicated toolset for isogeometric analysis. Regarding the unification of Topo and Mesh toolsets, the grouping of the functions is now the same between Topo and Mesh. The first three categories of every toolset concern topological modifications. The topology preparation and meshing is accomplished under one unified toolset, avoiding unnecessary switching between Topo and Mesh. This is also facilitated by the existence of the Faces Draw Mode button, which allows to visualize the model in Mesh View mode while in Topo module, and vice versa. The available operations of the direct edit mode depend both on the draw mode as well as on the hovered entities. Moving to the merging and modification of functions, several functions have been merged together. For example, the function Topo Faces New and Modify Fill Manual have been replaced by the Create Fill function. All Topo and Mesh project functions have been unified under the Modify project, which is identical either invoked from the Topo or from the Mesh toolsets. For the complete list of functions that have been merged or unified, please refer to the Smooth Migration document, which can be accessed from the Release Highlights window. The interface of the functions has been redesigned in order to have a common look and feel among different functions. For example, Extrude, Plane Cut, Project, and Bridge have a similar interface. All this functionality is also implemented inside Direct. Let's proceed with a live demo. The task here is to start with a 3D geometry, proceed with cleanup, extract the middle surface, and then mesh it without switching among the toolsets. We use the Mesh toolset. All topological actions that are necessary for the preparation of the file will be applied through that toolset. Switch to Topo Draw mode. Activate the Direct Edit Areas option either by pressing the respective button or by using a shortcut. The opening will be filled. Select the red cones and from the context menu select Fill. Select the whole chain of cones that constitute the opening using the loop. Activate the Apply Tangency option to follow the curvature of the surface and press OK. We proceed with the next area where the cube has to be created. Still in the Direct Area mode, select one cone of the hole using Control. Additional cones can be added to selection with simple clicks. From the context menu, we select Bridge. We select the target face and to delete the enclosed area. Press OK. To clean up geometrical errors, we press right mouse button and with the Select Multiple option, select all the problematic faces. From the context menu, select Heal. Now the geometry is ready to be skinned. From the Create group of buttons, select Skin. Clicking on a face, the whole closed volume gets selected, and with middle mouse button, we proceed with skin. The next step is to mesh the skin part. From the Cell Mesh group, select Mesh. The global mesh parameters will be used for the meshing. As we can see, the mesh parameters window has been redesigned. The perimeters and the features option tabs have been omitted, and their settings have been moved to the Basic tab and to the New Options tab. The feature-specific settings can now be found in the Features tab next to the treatment checkbox of each feature. For more details regarding the new Mesh Parameters window, please refer to the Smooth Migration document. Select the whole part and middle-click to proceed with meshing. We will focus on the mesh improvement of the depicted area using the Direct functionality. Select areas and join the depicted cones by clicking on it. Switch to Elements and drag the triad to the opposite one to omit them. Still in Elements, drag the depicted nodes to fix the quads. Paste the nodes here by dragging the one at the position of the other to omit the two triads. Switch to areas and delete the unnecessary hot point. The mesh of the area has been improved. Further improvement can be achieved with additional operations, such as correct node number assignment, reconstruct, and so on. Thank you for watching.